Hello everyone. So in this video we'll be studying the topic law of conservation of energy. So let's begin. Now when we talk about the law of conservation of energy, the very first thing which we need to study is its statement. So law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor it can be destroyed. It can only be transformed from one form to another. And most importantly, energy in a system remains constant or fixed. So this is the most important statement of law of conservation of energy. Energy in a system remains conserved or constant or fixed. And this is what we need to prove in different kinds of systems. So now the next topic which we need to study is what actually is a system? System kya hota hai physics ke terms mein? So you see, when we have a lot of components, so they all can be generalized in a single term and they can be said as a system. So ek system kya hota hai, dher sare components ke collection ko hum system kehte hain. Now systems are of two types, open system and closed system. Now the difference in between these two terms are, in open system we do not have any kinds of boundaries, but in case of a closed system all the components are confined in a fixed boundary. So we'll be studying the conservation of energy taking into consideration a closed system. Now when the movement is considered in a system, jab bhi kisi system mein hum movement ko consider karte hain, so they can take place in two types. First is the vertical movement. Theek hai, koi bhi component vertically move kar sakta hai upar se niche. And the second type of movement is the horizontal movement. Aise aise body move kar sakti hai. So today we'll be studying the topic of conservation of energy in case of a simple pendulum. So let's begin. So this is the diagram of a simple pendulum. Let's talk about the construction of a simple pendulum. You see, the pendulum is attached with a rigid support. So this is just to restrict the vertical movement. The second component is a thread with the help of which we attach a metallic ball. What do we call this metallic ball? We call it bob. So this is the construction of a simple pendulum. Now when we talk about the movement of a pendulum, there are three most important positions which we need to analyze. In this diagram you can see that the center position is called as the mean position, and the other two positions at the ends are called the extreme position. So we'll be comparing the mechanical energies at every point, at these three points in this simple pendulum. So let's begin. Now let's say that the movement of a pendulum begins from its mean position. A mean position se ye move karte hue ek jayega extreme position pe. So this is how it is going to move. Now if you look closely, what will happen at the extreme position? At the extreme position, the body will come to rest for a very little moment of time. Bahut kam samay ke liye extreme position pe ball rest pe aayegi, and then it will move back to its mean position. So now if the body is coming to rest at the extreme position, agar body rest pe aa rahi, that means its velocity will be zero. Now this is what we need to analyze. Agar velocity zero hai, to what will be the kinetic energy? Kyunki kinetic energy ka to formula hota hai half mv square. So that means at the extreme position the velocity is equal to zero, and therefore the kinetic energy will also be equal to zero. So yahan se ek question ban sakta hai that which kind of energy is zero at the extreme position in case of a simple pendulum. The answer is kinetic energy, and the reason, because its velocity is equal to zero. Now what about the potential energy? See, potential energy ka formula hota hai m into g into h, where m is mass, g is acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height from the ground. So you can see at the extreme position that the body is at a certain height from the ground. Now kinetic energy zero, potential energy mgh. So what will be mechanical energy at the extreme position? It will be equal to mgh. So ye hamara nikal gaya mechanical energy at the extreme position. Agar aapne ek extreme position pe nikal liya mechanical energy, so at the other extreme position also the answer will remain same, because the distance from the mean position is same and the ball is at the same height. So therefore agar aapne kisi bhi ek position pe mechanical energy nikal li, kisi bhi extreme position pe, so it will be same. Okay, so final answer, the mechanical energy at the extreme position is equal to mgh. Now let's move on to the mean position. Now what you can notice in the mean position is that there is no height from the ground. Ball और ग्राउंड के बीच में कोई भी हाइट नहीं है. एंड इफ देर इज नो हाइट देन विच काइंड ऑफ एनर्जी विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो? इट विल बी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, क्योंकि पोटेंशियल एनर्जी का फॉर्मूला होता है एम जी एच. अगेन एक क्वेश्चन यहाँ से बन सकता है, विच काइंड ऑफ एनर्जी विल बी जीरो एट द मीन पोजिशन इन केस ऑफ अ सिंपल पेंडुलम? सो द आंसर इज पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. रीजन, क्योंकि हाइट जीरो हो जाती है. Now, इस बार पोटेंशियल एनर्जी यहाँ पे जीरो हो गई, बट वॉट अबाउट काइनेटिक एनर्जी? काइनेटिक एनर्जी विल बी इक्वल टू हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर. बट इस पूरे डायग्राम में हम देख सकते हैं दैट वी डोंट हैव द वैल्यू फॉर वेलोसिटी. सो वॉट वील डू इज हम वेलोसिटी को उस फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करेंगे जो हमारे पास ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट है. हम एक्स्ट्रा कोई वेरिएबल यहाँ पे नहीं अटैच करेंगे. बट हाउ विल इट बी डन? ये होगा कैसे? रिमेंबर द थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, विच इज v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. अब ये तो हो गई final position. Initial position इसकी body की क्या होगी? Body is coming from the extreme position. So अगर initial position थी extreme position, final position है mean position, so the initial velocity will be equal to zero. And therefore v square will be equal to 2gh. यहाँ से हमने v square की value 2gh निकाल ली. Now what we need to do is simply substitute v square in the formula of half mv square. Kinetic energy में हम इसको substitute कर देंगे. Now kinetic energy is equal to half mv square, but v square के जगह हम लिखेंगे 2gh. So overall what will be kinetic energy now? It will be again equal to mgh. Again let's find out the mechanical energy at the mean position. See, kinetic energy is equal to mgh, potential energy is equal to zero. So what will be mechanical energy? It will be equal to mgh. और इस चीज़ से हमने ये प्रूव कर दिया, इस डेरिवेशन से वी हैव प्रूव्ड दैट द टोटल मैकेनिकल एनर्जी एट द एक्सट्रीम पोजिशन इज इक्वल टू द टोटल मैकेनिकल एनर्जी एट द मीन पोजिशन. बस चेंज क्या हो रहा है? एनर्जी एक फॉर्म से दूसरे फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट हो जा रही है. कहीं पे काइनेटिक एनर्जी के फॉर्म में थी तो कहीं पे पोटेंशियल एनर्जी के फॉर्म में हो गई. बट द टोटल एनर्जी, दैट मीन्स द टोटल मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इज कंजर्व्ड. वो कॉन्स्टेंट है, वो चेंज नहीं हुई है. एंड दिस इज वॉट वी नीड टू प्रूव इन द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी, दैट टोटल एनर्जी इन अ सिस्टम रिमेन्स कंजर्व्ड. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. आई होप आप लोगों को ये चीज़ समझ में आया होगा. वील मीट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंक यू एवरीवन.